Hello. There's nothing like performing in front of a live audience, but be that as it may, we need to be safe. So I hope you're all keeping safe. Today I have chosen to perform works by women composers, two of whom are African Americans. The first one is Clara Schumann, whom we know best as the wife of Robert Schumann. However, it is important to remember that Clara, during their time, was one of the most famous and one of the most sought-after concert pianists in Europe. In fact, she was the main breadwinner of the family, and she could earn more in a three-week period through concerts compared to what Robert could sometimes earn in 1 year of composing and editing. When you consider that, and you also consider the fact that she had to take care to manage a household with 8 children, and she had to travel long distances in order, via stagecoach, by the way, in order to go to her various concert engagements. And then Robert depended on her for artistic as well as psychological support. It is hard to understand how she could have had time to compose, but compose she did. And what I will be playing first is the Nocturne, her Nocturne, which was one of Robert's favorites. And then follow that with a Scherzo, one of the two that she composed. The second composer, Florence Price, was the first woman of African-American descent to have a composition performed by a major symphony orchestra. In 1933, her symphony number 1 was performed by the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. And in fact, her piano concerto had the premiere the year after. So why is it that we hardly ever hear of Florence Price, despite the fact that she had more than 300 compositions to her name, including 4 symphonies, 1 piano concerto, and 2 violin concerti? Well, in 1943, she wrote a letter to Serge Koussevitzky, conductor of the Boston Symphony Orchestra at the time, and she wrote, "Dear Mr. Koussevitzky, I am a woman. I have Negro blood in my veins. And now that I've told you the worst part about me, might you consider looking into a symphony that I have just finished composing?" Well, there was no response. No response even to a second letter. That encapsulates for me the problems, the challenges that women, especially women of color like Florence Price, have had to face. Now, the piece that I'm going to be playing, her Dances in the Canebrakes, was actually composed by her during the year that she died. So it's a late composition. It has a subtitle. It says Dances in the Canebrakes, based on authentic Negro rhythms. So you will hear bits of rag, bits of the cakewalk in various places. But what I like most about it is I think, at least this is my observation, that it has less European influence than earlier piano compositions, at least the ones that I know. And so it has a certain simplicity that appeals to me and that I think is American. The last piece, Troubled Water by Margaret Bonds. By the way, Margaret Bonds was a student of Florence Price. Troubled Water is an adaptation of Wade in the Water, a spiritual, one of many coded songs used by Harriet Tubman in order to communicate with the slaves. In the lyrics of the spiritual, the slaves are told to get off the trails and go into the water as the slave catchers and their dogs approach. And the idea is that by getting off the trail, they will not leave a scent, and therefore the dogs will not be able to follow them. Anyway, there are so many things that Margaret Bonds does with this piece, but I'd just like to point out the ending. In the ending, she uses some jazzy syncopated rhythms, you know, sort of like pum 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 pum. And to me, what she was trying to depict was the joy, the jubilation, the triumphant feeling that the slaves must have had at journey's end. So, from the triumphant back to the introspective, as I start with Clara Schumann's Nocturne. By the way, I'm not sure. I said that the Florence Price work has three movements. So two Schumanns, the Florence Price work, which has three movements, and then Margaret Bonds' work.
Thank you. Thank you.